Hello, so welcomes back everyone. AnthWolf here with even more Star Wars The Old Republic, playing as my Sith Inquisitor Veriia. Here just orbiting the planet of Korriban after checking in with Overseer Harkon concerning our potential new apprentice. Obviously he's running through the various trials that the newest batch of acolytes are going through. And now we are looking for a ritual which will help stop the deterioration of our body or cure us of the Force Walk ritual and the ghosts that are getting louder in our heads over time. And then potentially turning around and dealing with Darth Thanaton again. So, our first lead is to travel to the planet Belsavis, which Andronicus did mention potentially has a Republic prison. Obviously it's a top secret facility, and it's here in the distant outer rim. So let's get ourselves underway. Where is Belsavis? Ah, here we are. Officially, Belsavis is a sparsely populated Republic world dominated by Arctic plains. Its only notable feature is the rare tropical rifts that break up the expanses of ice, heated by natural geothermal vents, and home to a surprising diversity of plant life. In truth, Belsavis is an ultra-secure prison colony, established by the Republic, and until recently the prison's existence was top secret, but it was discovered by the Empire, and it has resulted in rumors spreading throughout the galactic underworld. The prison is now in a state of lockdown, and both Republic and Imperial militaries have a presence on the scene. And indeed they do. You're meant to be coming here between level 41 and 44, obviously. We are currently max level at 65 right now. But that's not the end of the world.
We've arrived at the Belsavis spaceport.
Good. We'll have to work quickly if we're to find a cure for your strange ailment. We know that a Sith called Darth Thanaton suffered a similar problem. His power became too much for him, and he began to deteriorate. We also know that he went to Belsavis in search of a recovered device that he believed could fix him, whatever that means.
You haven't learned anything new about the device, then?
Nothing beyond the diagrams Thanaton himself left. I'm afraid technology isn't my area of expertise. I've looked into Belsavis. There is indeed evidence that the Rakata were here, and that they built some kind of monumental prison.
The Rakata on Belsavis? My friend, you trade in myths and wonders! Myths and wonders!
The Republic have arrived since, however, and built their own prison. Whatever this device is, we'll have to navigate two prisons to get to it.
I'll destroy that prison piece by piece, if I have to.
Fortunately, that work has already begun. The Empire recently discovered the Republic's prison and staged a massive prison break.
Saves us the trouble of breaking in, I guess.
It also means the planet is in chaos. And any trail Darth Thanaton left will have been obliterated.
I don't need Darth Thanaton's trail. Give me the information and I'll find the device.
Without a trail to follow? Or any field experts in ancient alien technology? You're good, but I don't know if you're that good. But while perusing the Republic prison logs, I discovered a familiar name. The Circle. A group of criminal technologists NICTO I once employed. They never met a system they couldn't slice, or a machine they couldn't reverse engineer. Perhaps they can interpret Darth Thanaton's diagrams on Belsavis.
I hope you're right about this.
The Circle sliced into an ancient computer system that had the Empire's best paleotechnologists stumped. You won't find anyone better, on Belsavis or anywhere.
I bet one of the guardhouses has a record of where they were kept. I've seen my share of prisons.
We must be careful. Belsavis is a place of unknown danger. But be quick. The dates on Darth Aratus' records show his condition worsening rapidly.
Great. So yeah, the Empire at the moment is staging a prison break, causing some of the prisoners to obviously interrupt and disrupt the Republic's efforts to keep control on the planet, which works in the Empire's favor. So it looks like Talos and Ashura want to speak to us.
Always warms my circuits, Master. Reminds me I am still functioning.
Trying to figure who we should take down to the planet with us. I might take Andronicus, actually. We haven't really ran with him much since Tatooine. And, as he said, he has known his share of prisons. Probably not voluntarily. Obviously, we need to probably go through the Belsavis orbital station before we get down to the Empire's staging point here on the planet. We will need to find someone to make contact with to assist Imperial efforts here on the world. I think that contact's actually on the orbital station itself. And Belsavis as a world, basically we are just involving ourselves primarily with the prison complex, and that's broken into 3 or 4 different sections. I think there's a minimum, maximum, high security wing, and then there's a final area that might be called the vault. Let's take Andronicus with us.
I'll await your goal. Ready.
Excellent. You don't have a lot of health. Neither do we, for that matter, but we have been desynced, or world level synced to level 46, which explains things. Andronicus, you can be a DPS for us. There you go. Right, let us begin. So I think before we go in search of the guard captain, who might be able to lead us to the Nikto, the crack where this Rakata device is. The Rakata, of course, you'll probably know, are the race known also as the Infinite Empire, a race thousands of years prior to this game who basically controlled most of the known galaxy. And then, I can't remember what happened to the Rakata, but they kind of disappeared for one reason or another. But I forgot what event may have caused it. Probably far too many wars, I imagine. Yeah, Imperial Attaché begins the story arc here on Belsavis.
Iperum, chin nampa al adam, nekne kam. Laporam amga, mamni nikag. Nagnaya mamni kamgam.
Now you've got me interested.
Umogala apayang. Nela ma ini amka amgam. Hanang nimu, kemgam karayangwa.
The Imperial Guard are a form of special forces within the Sith hierarchy. Obviously, we need to speak to Commander Callum here, who is leading the efforts here in Belsavis for one reason or another. Let's see what he wants.
Approach. You have garnered the attention of my master, the Emperor. He foresees you performing great deeds on Belsavis, and he sends this message. Do not disappoint him.
If he gave me an objective to fulfill, it would help.
In time. First, familiarize yourself with the Belsavis system. This planet holds the Republic's dirtiest secret, a maximum security prison, home to the galaxy's most depraved convicts. We've come to free them. Specifically, the Dread Masters. Elder Sith who could change the course of the war.
The Empire is risking much to free these Sith. Why?
The Dread Masters possess the unique ability to cripple an entire enemy force with terror. We've deployed special operations groups to release them. They freed prisoners and sparked riots. But during the chaos, we lost contact with all 5 teams. You will need to re-establish contact, and, if necessary, relaunch the operation to free the Dread Masters.
I like the idea of Sith Lords owing their freedom to me.
The shuttle will drop you at the last known location of Operations Group 5. Find Lord Medishus. Help him fan the flames of the riot. Minimum resources, maximum results. That's how we avoid disappointing the Emperor.
Yeah, I have my own reasons for going down to Belsavis, but as we say, it's nice if more Sith owe us favours. So Agent Brandis wants to have a word with us, but that's, well, it could be important, but it's not on my mind right now. Well, we can go to Section X from here as well. You know what, I've never actually been to Section X before. I think it revolves around getting a new companion for ourselves. But not something I've ever looked into. Right, let's have a look at the world. Welcome to Belsavis, everyone. We are currently here in the bottom right of the screen, here in minimum security. And if we zoom out, as I say, we have minimum, high security, maximum security, and the tomb. Not the vault. The tomb. And unfortunately, we've got this who Belsavis is controlled by right now, and I don't think I can disable it. No, that's something different. You might need to reload the game. Anyhow, let's have a look at the map here. We're in the Imperial Lodgement. This is where the guard captain is. They'll learn where the Nikto are, but we want to get over to Lord Medichas first. Let's just quickly log out and log back in to get rid of that little pop-up there. Otherwise, I'll just frustrate me for the rest of this video. So feel free to pause. This will give you a brief overview of the Chapter 3 story arc and where we're up to right now. So this is looking maybe for a physical cure, and maybe we may need to travel to Voss to seek a mental cure to subdue the Force spirits once again. Maybe. Pop into this building. Someone's not happy.
Welcome, my lord. I assumed Commander Callum sent you to help. I'm Lord Medishus, leader of Operations Group 5. We started this riot by arming prisoners and pointing them at their Republic captors. But our primary goal is to extract certain inmates held deep within the prison.
Commander Callum said they were Sith Lords.
Correct. The Dread Masters. They can reach out through the Force and pierce their enemies with terror. Whole armadas surrender to them without firing a shot. The Republic claimed the Dread Masters were killed in the last war. Returning them to the field would be a crowning achievement.
Do you have a fix on the Dread Masters' location?
The Republic moved them into the deep prison. We've heard nothing since. Meanwhile, the Warden brought in a hard-headed off-world enforcer, Ellis Ruger. He's here to close our exit corridor. If the Republic isn't stopped, they'll retake this landing zone. Without an exit, our prison break will fail.
I've held off army units. Prison guards will be like wading through dung.
Just the attitude we need to break them. They're cowering behind force fields, sending droids to do their dirty work. These Warden droids have enough firepower to incapacitate a small army. The rioters are losing hope, but we can reignite their rage. Destroy enough droids and the convicts will smell blood. They'll practically defend our landing zone for us.
If a few broken droids will spark the convicts' fury, I'll set this riot ablaze.
Impress the rioters with your power and the droids' weakness. Then they'll fight our enemy for us.
Okay. So before we can actually start searching for the Dread Masters, we need to secure minimum security. To do that, we need to destroy 3 warden droids and prove that the Republic's automated defenses aren't invincible. Nice little, the biome here in Belsavis is very interesting, very glacial, like Tatooine, and yet, as they mentioned, it has various geothermal vents, which give you these kind of almost jungle-like habitats. So I think, are they here? No, they're up on the higher level. We do need to go this way eventually, but not just yet. Various rioters who can't tell friend from foe. So yeah, this is where people, the Republic, don't want anyone to know about or forgotten about, get dropped off. And the most glaring offenders get popped into the tomb, never to be really seen from again. Here's our warden droids. How do we start this again? That worked out. Now, one more droid. You'll do. Nice and easy. Let's quick travel back over to the lodgment. I never actually saw where the quick travel node was for our base of operations here, minimum security. Might as well put our eyes on it. Alright. Next to the transport service droid. And there is another transport node, a quick travel node in the cantina, which is through there.
Droids are no more. I hope the rioters took note.
Have no fear. Thousands of prisoners already move against the droids. More devotees follow your footsteps every minute. Many have died in the process, but that's normal.
Minimum effort, maximum results, I see.
They will occupy the guards' attention with little more energy on our part. A fine move. Thanks to you, the inmates have turned from whipped dogs into predators. Still, we need more convicts on our side. Turn this mob into an army and the Republic will be permanently occupied. An army begins with generals. We must provide the prisoners with the leadership they require.
There must be plenty of leadership material locked up here. Break them out and put them to work.
Exactly. There's a carbonite storage facility in the intake yards, full of frozen convicts. Some were rebellion leaders, others simply murdered every guard they found. We need both persuasions.
Releasing them into the general population should prove entertaining.
Splendid. Though the unfreezing process won't be simple. Prisoner, what of your mission into the carbon gallery?
Crisis response unit ambushed us. I got away. Only me.
Excellent. Ruger took the bait. Now you can free the frozen prisoners and wipe out the crisis response unit all at once.
Your trap just made my job more dangerous.
But the payoff will be considerable. Without his top men, Ruger must scramble to defend his station. Destroy the guards and defrost the prisoners. They'll turn this riot into an organized army. Then we'll have safe passage to extract the Dread Masters.
So great. We have the crisis response unit to deal with on our way to releasing some convicts with leadership potential. Ah, it's actually down this way as well. Ah, well, that's handy. I guess we can locate the guard captain while we're down here in the carbon gallery then. And is that straight ahead? Ah, either way. We can follow this path. I wonder what you're shooting at. Oh, we have some wildlife here. Bog wings and... is it Varactyl? Well, some more convicts and... some riot police. Who are about to die horribly. Oh, you interrupted me. Okay, let's have a look here. Oh, I see. Looks like there's definitely some dead bodies in there. First things first, though, let's look into dealing with a crisis response unit. Need to clear this room out and we should be fine.
Nice.
Excellent. See all these people held in carbon freezing, like modules. Loot all the bodies, may as well help ourselves. Not as if they really have any way to complain. Ah, see the terminals. Anyone else? There's a few people, but we can just ignore them. The rioters will deal with them momentarily. You have found the carbonite flooring controls. A status readout warns that it's cut off from the main generator. Remaining power is only sufficient to fill one grid of soldiers. Grid 1 houses murderers with diagnosed criminal pathologies. They are likely to kill guards and other prisoners if released. Grid 2 houses agitators on large-scale protests and riots. They're likely to organize revolts if released, possibly with less violence. Which would you like to free?
A few psychopaths should keep the Republic awake at night.
Energy diverted to Grid 1. See, this may not be the best idea. But as long as their attention's focused on the Republic, that's fine. Hi.
I hope you're proud. Your time on Bell Savis is up.
Marshal Ruger.
You speak that way to a Sith Lord.
I'd speak this way to the Emperor himself if the coward dared show his face. I've been cracking heads 20 years this spring. Every Sith I've downed thought the law never applied to him. So let me make this perfectly clear. You've made a mistake. Time to pack up and fly home.
You think you scare me?
You'll learn. They all do.
So that's the individual the Republic's hired to try and whip this prison back into shape and restore order. We need to go speak to Lord Medichas once again to let him know that the convict leaders have been released. But let's go find this guard captain to see if he knows anything about the Nictor. We need to learn more about this Ricarda artifact. Ooh, hello. Something going on down here.
Come on, cough it up. Every name, every date, every blasted key.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Cattle are in the slaughterhouse now, partner. Don't play dumb.
Oh, that prisoner list. Of course. Right here.
I'll be taking that list.
Right. Sorry, Sith. You want the list, it's yours. We'll just be going.
Yeah, we'll be getting out of your way. Don't hurt us, please.
Don't know why you bothered. You're just gonna kill me like all the others, aren't you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Last I checked, it was your empire that opened all the cages. Let freaks like them out. I just hope my family made it out of here alive. But you don't care, do you? What is it you want, anyway?
There's a group of Nikto with an inordinate love of technology.
Yeah, I remember them. Ran off into one of those big vaults a few days ago to do whatever it is they do. Don't know if they're still alive, though.
I am most grateful.
Ooh, overkill. Didn't just bisect him once. So, just to point out, the Cathar escaped prisoner seemed quite skittish. Why did the human have a name? That always puts me slightly on edge that therefore they're gonna come back to bite us. Both prisoners seemed rather skittish about the situation. Could have been an act, though. Right, to get ourselves back over to the Imperial Lodgement. We need to locate the circle now. Apparently they went into a vault, which looks like it still might be in minimum security. But I won't worry about that just yet.
There was only enough power to thaw the best prisoners. I unleashed the worst murderers I could find.
The convicts were violent before. With psychopaths at the helm, there's no telling what crimes they'll commit. Ruger will not be pleased.
He called to threaten me. He seemed unafraid.
Ruger's tamed prisons before, even restored order to Coruscant's depths. It's time we end his career. The only thing keeping us from his throat are the force fields guarding his base. Luckily, a mad Deveronian prisoner, Golan, has the key.
Golan will surrender the key. He has no choice.
The Deveronian may see things differently. He knows the key is valuable. Plus, he's trained in the Force and highly violent. The Republic tried executing him 4 times. That's when they shipped him to Belsavis. Now, Golan thinks he can't die. He's refusing to hand over the key to Ruger's guard station.
Yes, Golan may not fear death, but soon he'll beg for it.
Save your torments for Ruger. This mission simply demands a quick kill and the key in our hand. Golan roams near the resettlement camps, in the open areas where wise inmates leave him alone. Make your way there. The longer we delay, the more likely Ruger will change the lock frequency on the security fields.
Okay. So we need to find this immortal Deveronian. Deveronians are the ones with 2 horns on their head, I think. Right. So we just need to follow the rightmost path. And it should lead us to where we need to go. So we're going to be bypassing the warden droids once again. There we go, nice and easy. Oh, not this one. Unfortunately. Oh, hello. So when you start aggroing some of the enemies in this area, other enemies will, like, jump down to join them. Let's go on supplies, let's mess them up. Get his attention. There he is. There you go, he wasn't too difficult. Take the security field access key and that should let us gain access to Marshal Ruger's base of operations. Now there is, we follow this main road up and then to the left, a forward Imperial base here in minimum security. Here we are. Another quick node. This should already be unlocked, but we'll do it anyway.
It's done. I have the key to the security fields.
We must strike quickly, before word of Golan's death spreads. Ruger is finally vulnerable. If you're ready, we can end his campaign and secure this landing zone for good.
Tell me where this lawman is, and our problems are over.
Ruger and his men are in a guard station. He believes it's more secure than the main intake building. Use the security key to drop their shields. My teams will cut off Ruger's backup. No one gets in, no one gets out. We'll give you time to work. Just make sure Ruger doesn't escape.
I've been waiting to get my hands on Ellis Ruger.
His men know what to do in battle. Any shock we cause will wear off quickly. This is his stronghold. Bring everything you have and every ally you trust. We will get no second chance.
And we're going back onto the main road and just traveling a little bit further to the east. Gain access to this guard building. Most of wildlife is neutral towards us. Mind there's enough riders here to cause issues, not just the Republic's guards. Here we are. Andronicus is getting his bloodlust out of his system. There's a bonus to defeat 15 of the Republic forces here. We can do that. There you go. Force field dropped. Ruger's just up there. Group. It's the bonus complete. Now we can speak to Marshal Ruger without any interruptions. Well, there's another couple of groups. In fact, there's a riot officer over there who looks like he's using a vibro sword. But he won't interfere with our conversation.
Well, now, there's two ways you can leave, Imperial. Cuffed down or feet first.
I'm walking away from this. You won't be so lucky.
Feet first it is.
There you go.
Hold your gloating. Get it over with.
Make your peace. It is over.
Ruger! Come in, Ellis Ruger. This is Warden Grawl. We're taking fire and can't reach your position. What's your status?
Roger that. This is Ellis Ruger. Wish I could help, but I'm busy dying for a worthless cause. Over.
You're not Ruger. What's going on? Wait, I've seen you on our cameras.
Obviously not.
What do you want?
My only desire is to watch your face as I do this.
You monster! Ellis Ruger! He was the last hope for law and order on Balsamis! I won't forget this. Warden Grawl, out!
If he was the last hope, then I greatly worry for the Republic's efforts here in this world. Right. Let's go speak to Lord Medichas and let him know that the minimum security section of the planet should be sorted now. No problems on this end.
That was a rare occasion. We had half their numbers and still handed them their heads. Ruger must have been furious. I can only imagine the thrill of snuffing out his life.
Thrilling doesn't even begin to describe what it felt like to stick that lawman.
And as Ruger's screams fade, we know our landing zone won't be threatened again. If you'll excuse me, duty calls. I must re-establish contact with Commander Callum.
Lord Medishers. Come in, Lord Medishers.
I am here, Commander Callum. What is your will?
Ellis Ruger was blocking our signal. Your men re-established contact once he fell, but I've heard nothing from our other operations groups. Captain Van Dorn must be reached. Our mission is still in jeopardy.
I've defeated Ruger. The Republic's dealing with the riot. What's left?
The Republic may be the least of our worries in this prison.
Lord Medishers is right. That's why he'll defend the landing zone against further Republic interference. You will perform the rendezvous.
Captain Van Dorn was last seen in the high security wing. Find his camp, but be wary. The Republic is conducting strange experiments with the inmates there.
No, you don't know the half of it. Yeah. The Republic weren't just keeping these prisoners here for their health. I forgot what the project was called, but yeah, experimentation was right. Social experimentation, if anything. Okay, I think we'll end this video here. When we come back, I want to head into high security. Obviously, we do need to find the Nikto group known as the Circle, but I will probably do that once we've helped and completed the story arc here on Belsavis. Trying to think of which way we need to go to get into high security. I think the path we need to take somewhere down here. But yeah, we'll travel when we come back. We'll travel from the lodgement where we are right now and travel into high security to find this Captain Van Dorn and see what the situation is in that wing of the prison. But yeah, this of course has been AnthWolf playing Star Wars The Old Republic. Hope you've all enjoyed and I hope you all take care. And I'll see you for even more next time. Until then, bye bye now.